It all starts with a naked room. W-A-L-L-P-A-P-E-R Wallpaper. It's so limiting. Each strip is only half a meter wide. Here, the pattern width is the same as the strip width. And here, we have different height of the pattern repeats. The higher the pattern repeats, the higher the waste cost will be. However, more than 1x pattern width is the norm. Like this one. This 1x pattern strip is actually designed with a 3x pattern width. For some reason, most wallpapers have multiple pattern width. Why? Maybe. If we take a look at more modern wallpapers, it's the same here. Most of them are multiple repeats. Let us adjust them a bit. One time makes the repetition stand out. This is a good thing. It allows designers to be more creative. It forces designers to be more creative. But it also unveils more possibilities.
Pattern families.
With 1x pattern width, it's easier to create pattern families. This is one strip with 1x pattern width. Still just a single strip. But, if we create more strips in the same style, then we would get a pattern family. Pattern family. One example of an interesting pattern family is the alphabet. You can write your name or anything you want on the wall. But this isn't such a good idea. Strips comes from rolls, so each strip are supposed to start where the last one ended, which require a low pattern repeat. The pattern height is too high in these strips. We have to do something else than rolls.
Squares.
What if we change the way we apply wallpaper?
It's disruptive.
What if we, instead of strips from a roll, apply 1 square meter sheets. And then add the pattern family to the mix. Or the possibilities are endless. The alphabet with 1 square meter sheets.